Good morning, one and all. So let us start today's class. Before that, let me briefly explain about normal or Gaussian random variable, which is very, very important. Its PDF is like this, and it is denoted as like this. It is having a mean mu and variance sigma square. Obviously, the entire area under the graph of PDF must be 1. This indicates what it says. The entire area under the graph of PDF must be equal to 1. It is nothing but the total probability. Yeah, as I told you, its PDF is symmetric about its mean and it has a bell-shaped curve. Okay, so what happened was, so yesterday we started with normal random variable, or it is also called as what? Gaussian. You remember both names. Now here, so x is Gaussian or normal random variable with some mean mu and variance sigma square. Okay. Now then what we do is, so we need to make it in the standard form. It is called standardization. So what is the meaning of standardization? The normal random variable which has got zero mean and unit variance. So to make it standard, we go for what? Linear transformation. We go for linear transformation. What is the transformation? So we take another random variable y, define y equal to x minus mu by sigma. So it is in the form of y equal to ax plus b, where a and b are some scalars. Here what is a? 1 by sigma. What is b? Minus mu by sigma. It is just a linear function of x. Y is a linear function of what? X. Now what happens here? Y also normal random variable but having zero mean and unit variance. Then y becomes, what it becomes now? This y is nothing but standard normal. Standard normal random variable. Now, after making it standardization, we write standard normal what? CDF, cumulative distribution function. What is the notation? Generally, it is phi of y. So generally CDF notation was fx of x, something like that, right? But for case of normal random variable, we use this notation for the CDF. Now what is the definition of CDF? Obviously phi of y equal to probability that y is less than equal to y. Okay, now before that, now here what would be the PDF of this y? Before CDF, let me write PDF of y. Suppose if I ask you, what is a PDF of y? What is y? It is a standard normal random variable. That's why its PDF should be 1 by root 2 pi. So there is no sigma. In the last class, I told you sigma. It is not sigma. Sigma is not required. Why? Because what is sigma? Sigma equal to 1. No need to write. Okay. So 1 by root 2 pi e power minus y square by 2. Isn't it? So this is a PDF of standard normal random variable. I want CDF. Obviously, what is CDF? Integration of PDF. So CDF is nothing but probability that random variable is less than or equal to some value y. Now it simply says, what it says? It simply says, simply says, so probability that y is less than equal to y equal to integration minus infinity to y fi of t dt. Now this is phi of y. Now that is simply 1 by root 2 pi minus infinity to y e power minus t square by 2 dt. Now this is the standard normal CDF. Okay, but so this integral is very difficult to calculate. Each and every time you cannot calculate these values. That's why they gave you a table. Okay, so let me show you the table. Now this is a table of, I hope it is visible to you. This is a table of what? Standard normal CDF. Phi of z. Now for different value of z, you can get the value. Suppose, so if it is visible, you can clearly see here. What is phi of 1? What is phi of 1? Here. This is 0.8413. So for various values of y, you got the CDF values. This table gives you the standard normal CDF values for various values of parameter y or z. Here they mentioned the variable is z. So this table will be given to you in the exam. Okay, no need to remember anything. So these are table which are standard in form. So we'll give you in the exam all. So from this table, you need to get the values of standard normal CDF. I will share you this table in the LMS. You want to go through it once. Okay. Now, so whenever problem is given, we calculate up to this. Now this value can be, you can get from table. Okay. So that is a simple logic. The only thing is, so this is the not the CDF table. This is not a CDF actually. What is this? This is standard CDF. Okay. If it is not in the standard form, you should make it standard. I told you in the last class, suppose we have something like p that x is greater than or equal to 20, you want to calculate this value, or less than or equal to 20. For example, x is less than or equal to 20, but what is x? X is a normal random variable which is not in the standard form. Then what do? You subtract mean on the both sides. Then you divide with what? Sigma on both sides. Okay. So then what happens? X minus mu by sigma less than equal to 20 minus mu by sigma. Now this will be in the standard form. What will happen? Y is less than equal to 20 minus mu by sigma. For given value of mu and sigma, you calculate. Suppose you got like this, probably that y is less than or equal to 0.5. for example, it simply says that this is CDF of 0.5. okay, now how to get 0.5 CDF from this table? So somewhere here, what is 0.5 value? 0.6915. you get this value from the table. Okay, like this we calculate the probabilities. So as I told you, it is symmetric. Now this is the normal PDF and CDF. So these things I explained in the last class itself. So these are all, yeah, here. So there is something called symmetry. What do you mean by this is, here we calculate, suppose you want pi of suppose minus x, it is nothing but 1 minus pi of x. This is called symmetry. So that's why we only calculate for positive values of x. X or y, no need to confuse. If I write minus y, that equal to 1 minus pi of y. Suppose if I want pi of minus 0.5, what I will do? 1 minus pi of 0.5, which means if you know for positive values of this y, you can get for negative values of y. So like that we calculate for negative values of the CDF using symmetry. Okay. Next. So these things I explained in the last class itself. We solve this problem. Yeah. So this is the PDF. Okay. This is CDF. How it is? It is non-decreasing. I told you the properties of CDF. Okay. So what is the maximum value of that? 1. After that, it remains constant. It is increasing like this, and after some time, it is remaining constant at 1. Now, so actually, I told you just now, suppose CDF, if I ask you, what the probability that y is less than or equal to 0.7? What do? It is minus infinity to 0.7 PDF. Area under PDF, no? Okay. So here, so which means minus infinity to 0.7 this area. So what is this? Nothing but area. Okay. So if you know the graph of PDF, from that also you can get CDF values. Is it okay? Now this is nothing but pi. What is this? Nothing but CDF of 0.7. Okay. Yeah. Now, so we'll move on to one more important aspect of this probability, that is Q function. Very, very, very important. So what is the Q function? It is the complement of CDF. Okay. So what is CDF? Generally, what you written? Probably that x is less than or equal to z. Okay. But what is Q function says? Sorry. What is Q of z defined as? Probability that x is greater than z. Obviously, how to write x is greater than z? 1 minus probability that x is less than or equal to z. But what is this? This is CDF. What is CDF? Pi of z. So that's why Q function is a complement of standard normal CDF. Q function. So you'll encounter this Q function everywhere. You must know this Q function formulas. It is very, very important. How it is defined as Q of z, z is any variable, but probability that x is more than z. Obviously, 1 minus probability that x is less than or equal to z. But this is nothing but CDF. So that's why it is 1 minus pi of z. Q of z equal to 1 minus pi of z. This is Q function. This is what? CDF, standard normal CDF. Okay. Yeah, so the formula is like this. You must know this formula. Formula is quite simple, no? So we are writing from z to infinity. It is asking probability that x is more than z, which means z to infinity, everything is same. But what about CDF? What do you written, if you remember? Minus infinity to y we have written, right? You are writing z to infinity because it is asking for x more than z. Probability that x is more than z. Okay. Now, so this upper bound on the Q function. Yeah, it is widely used in the BER calculations. What is the BER means? Bit error rate. So we'll come to know these things in the later courses, but this is very, very, very important. One more thing. So we have a function for Q, table for Q function also. So this, for this integral, we have a standard table. Let me show you this. This is a Q function table. Here also, for different values of z, we have, they have written x. Okay, suppose what is Q of 0? 0.5, something like that. Q of 0.90. Okay, for various values of x, we have a q of x value. This is a standard table of q function. Is it okay? So we have a standard normal table, we have a q function table. So you can get the values of q function from this table. So this is given to you in the exam hall. Okay? It is widely used in the BER calculations. This is the q function PDF. Now it is also symmetric, just like CDF. If you want to know the q of minus 0.5, how to calculate that? 1 minus q of 0.5. So this is very, very important. So to calculate the negative values of q function, what we do? First we calculate the positive values and we subtract it from 1. Suppose if I ask you, what is q of minus 0.5? Should be equal to 1 minus q of 0.5. q of 0 is 0.5. Now after q function we go for two more functions, actually that is called error function. Okay, erf of x, it is called error function. How it is defined? Like this. ERF of 0 is 0. Obviously, 0 to integration 0 to 0 is nothing but 0. What is the ERF of infinity? That is 1. It is called error function. Now, in the same way, so this is a relation between error function and q function. Just now I told you q function integral. This is a q function integral and this is the error function integral. So if you do some little modifications, you will get the relation between q function and error function. This is the relation. This is also very, very, very important. You must know relation between error function and q function. We have one more function that is called complementary error function. How it is denoted as? ERFC. Please make a note of this. This is ERF. This is ERFC. C stands for what? Complementary. Obviously, what is ERFC of x? That is 1 minus ERF of x. So let me write here. As of now, we have seen standard functions, CDF, phi of y or phi of z, q function, q of z, and we have seen ERF, error function, and last one is ERFC of x. This C stands for what? Complementary. Complementary. Obviously, what is ERFC of x? That equal to 1 minus ERF of x, or vice versa. Now this is the integral of complementary error function. Finally, this relation between ERFC and q function. Obviously, so what is the difference? 1 minus of this. If remember, only one relation, other relation you can easily write. So here what I want to say is, you must know q function, ERF function, ERFC function, and not only that, you must know relation between q function and ERF function, q function and ERFC function. If you remember one, other can easily derive. Okay, we have a table for ERFC and ERF also. I am not showing here, but there are tables also. They too have a tables, standard tables, just like q function and standard normal CDF. Okay, now here, so let me conclude by saying this. We have a normal, standard normal CDF, q function, ERF function, complementary error function. Now all these have got their own tables. Okay, they got their own standard tables. Clear? This is the CDF. Not only that, you must know the relation between Q function and ERF function, Q function and ERFC function. So if you know one function, other can be easily derived because they are complement of each other. What is the one more relation? ERFC of x equal to 1 minus ERF of x. They are just complementary. Okay. So this is about some standard functions and the tables. All these have got their own tables, so which are in standard in nature. Okay. This is a Q function table. I will share you the table in LMS. You can download. Now, so let us take one problem. Now, this is completely, we are dealing with no communications. What it says is, a binary message is transmitted as a signal, that is either minus 1 or plus 1. So generally, binary means only 2. Generally, you might have studied 0 or 1. But here we call minus 1 or plus 1. Okay? So we are transmitting a signal. What signal? Binary signal. Something like this. What is this? This is plus 1. This is minus 1. This is plus 1. We are transmitting this data. Okay? What it is called? Actually, this is called digital data. So nowadays everything is digital in nature. So we transmit digital signals. What is digital? It is sequence of ones and zeros or ones and minus ones. That's it. Anyway. So we are transmitting through a channel. Corrects the transmission with additive normal noise with a mean mu and variance sigma square. Okay. The receiver concludes that the signal is minus 1 or plus 1 was transmitted if the value of the received signal is less than 0 or greater than or equal to 0, respectively. What is the probability of error? So I request all of you to go through the problem one more time. Okay. Now here we are creating a system that is called communication system. Right. Now this is a system. You take any communication system, there are three blocks. What are they? Transmission, transmitter. It is called transmitter. This is called receiver. In between we have a channel. These are the three basic building blocks of any communication system. Okay. Now generally what happens? You transmit some information to other place. Okay. In between there is a path. That is called channel. Now the problem with channel is it adds noise to the original message signal. Suppose you are making a phone call to your friend. You are a transmitter, other person the receiver. So in between there is a channel. What the channel will do? It will corrupt your voice. That's why sometimes you receive a broken language or broken voice. Why? Because there is a noise that is being added in the path, in the transmission path, that is simply called as channel. Is it okay? So because of channel, we get so many problems. Because it is adding some noise to our original message. It is corrupting our message. Anyway, so we are transmitting a signal which is a plus one or minus one through a channel. Now the channel is adding some noise. So what is noise? It is nothing but an unwanted signal, which is not wanted or which is not desirable is called noise. Okay. Noise random in nature. Why? Because nobody knows how much noise will be added. So it is highly random in nature. That's why it is modeled as a random variable. Now in the problem they mentioned the noise is a normal random variable with zero mean and variance sigma square. Okay. Now n is a random variable. Please listen carefully. Now n is a noise which is Gaussian or normal. Gaussian random variable with zero mean and variance sigma square. So here the noise is not in the standard form. Why? Because to be in the standard form, we should have a zero mean and unit variance, which is not the case here. Anyway, so now what is happening here? So we have a random variable n, otherwise let me write some other notation for avoid ambiguity. N is a random variable with zero mean and sigma square variance. Okay, now here, so from the transmitter you get S. Okay, in the channel, what is adding? N. At the receiver, what do you receive? You receive S plus N. At the receiver, we get what? Your original signal plus some noise. Okay. Now, what is the job of the receiver? It has to decode or it has to reproduce what has been transmitted. Okay. Suppose you take a telephone communication. I am saying hello. You must listen hello only. Suppose if I say hello, if you listen something else, that is not the proper communication, isn't it? So whatever I'm talking to you, same thing should be produced at your phone, isn't it? So that's why receiver has to replicate the same thing that has been transmitted from the transmitter. Now, but here the receiver has a tough job of deciding. Okay, what it will decide? It will decide like this. If it is receiving S plus N, if S plus N is greater than or equal to 0, it says that plus 1 is transmitted. If the received signal S plus N is negative, it says that minus 1 is transmitted. But it can go wrong. This is the rule. It is following this rule. The receiver is following this rule, but it may go wrong. That is called error. Okay. So what may happen sometimes? So because of noise, what may happen is, suppose you're transmitting plus one, but at the receiver, you may receive minus one. This is called error. Or reverse may happen. You may transmit minus one, you may receive plus one. It is also one more type of error. There are two possibilities for error. Plus 1 may become minus 1 or vice versa. Minus 1 may become plus 1. What is the reason for this? The reason is noise. Okay. Now, let me take like this. So, please listen carefully. So, we have transmitted plus 1. We have sent plus 1. Okay. At the receiver, what do you receive? S plus N. S is plus 1 because you are transmitted plus 1. What you receive? S plus N, which means you receive 1 plus N. But at the receiver, so what do you decode? If S plus N is positive, you say that it is 1. Okay, which means if 1 plus N is greater than or equal to 0, what do you decode? Decode as plus 1. Okay. Here, suppose reverse may happen. Okay. So you're transmitted minus 1. What do you receive? Minus 1 plus N. Here, if it is more than 0, you call this is plus 1. So let me write here. Let me take only one by one case. You are transmitted plus 1, which means S equal to plus 1. What do you receive? You receive S plus N, that is 1 plus N. Here, there are two possibilities. If it is greater than 0, we say that plus 1 is received. If it is less than 0, we say that minus 1 is received. Now, when the error will happen? When the error will happen? Suppose 1 plus n is less than 0, which means n is less than or equal to 1. You say that minus 1 is transmitted. But actually, what is transmitted? Plus 1. Okay, so there is one type of error. This is case 1. What may happen? You transmit plus 1, but at the receiver, if the noise is less than 1, you may decode as minus 1. So there is a mismatch. Then that is called error. Case 1. Case 2. What may happen? Case 2. What may happen? You are transmitted minus 1. What do you receive? Minus 1 plus n. If it is greater than 0, you say that plus 1 is transmitted. Which means, if n is greater than or equal to 1, you say that plus 1 is transmitted. But actually what is transmitted? Minus 1. So this is another type of error. The second type of error. But what is n? It is a noise which is a normal random variable. Please make a note of this. N is a noise which is modeled as a normal random variable with 0 mean and variance sigma square. Okay. Now, so let me take this error. When we get error, so they're asking probability of error. Which means when we get error, second type of error. I'm not saying this is the one type of error. Case 1 is case 2. Let me take case 2. So when n is greater than or equal to 1, I'll get an error. Now how to calculate this probability? We know that 1 minus p of n less than 1. This can be written like this. Now here, n is not in the standard form. Please make a note of this. Is it okay? So let us make it in the standard form. Why? Because if you make it in the standard form, you can go for standard normal CDF, a table. So n minus mu, mu is 0 anyway, no need to write anyway. N minus mu by sigma less than equal to 1 minus mu by sigma. Mu is given 0. Mu is 0. Now it is nothing but 1 minus p of n minus mu by sigma will become standard form. Let me write as it is. N minus mu by sigma less than. So let me not write mu. Mu is 0, no? So n by sigma less than 1 by sigma. So n by sigma is standard form. So what do you write? What do you write? This can be written as 1 minus pi of 1 by sigma. Understood? Now this is the, for what? This is a probability of error when minus 1 is transmitted but you are getting plus 1. But what about this probability? This error, probability of error. You are transmitting plus 1, you are getting minus 1. So both are safe. This is the second type of error. This is the probability of getting. So the probability of error for second type. For the first type, it is same. They are symmetric. Same thing will happen for first type. So these are the probability of errors. Suppose for example, sigma equal to 1. They gave you sigma equal to 1. Then what is the probability of error? Only one error let us take. 1 minus pi of 1. How to get pi of 1? From the table. What is pi of 1 from the table? Pi of 1. 0.8413, which means 1 minus 0.8413. You calculate, you will get the answer. This is the probability of error. What type of error? It may be plus 1 may become minus 1 or minus 1 may become plus 1. For both type of probable errors, same probability. Okay. Now this can be calculated in the using graph. Graph means this graph. Okay, here, so try to understand the things very carefully. This is 0. What we are saying here? When s plus 1 is greater than 0, we are decoding plus 1. Which means, whenever this PDF is greater than 0, this is the area which gives the probability of error. This is the region of error. When minus 1 is transmitted. This is, if you calculate this area, you get probability of error when minus 1 is transmitted. But, so what about reverse? Let me draw the graph here. Plus 1. Is 0. Now this is the region which indicates probability of error when the region of error when plus 1 is transmitted. How it is so? Why it is so? Why it is so? What are they? They are bell-shaped curves. Means what? They are PDFs. Okay, now, so why I am writing the graphs like this? Here, as I told you, what do you receive? At the receiver, you may receive 1 plus n or minus 1 plus n. Isn't it? So, you receive 1 plus n when plus 1 is transmitted. You receive minus 1 plus n when minus 1 is transmitted. Isn't it? Now, here what happens here? What about the mean of this? What is the mean of, suppose mean of n is 0, what is the mean of 1 plus n? 1. What is the mean of minus 1 plus n? Minus 1. Here, that's why this is what the PDF of the receiver when minus 1 is transmitted. Here, what is the mean? Minus 1. How can you say like that? Because it is symmetric about minus 1. As I told you, this normal PDF will be symmetric about its mean. So here this graph is symmetric about minus 1 means its mean is minus 1. At the receiver side, please make note of this. Now, this is a receiver side PDF having mean minus 1. So whenever this is greater than 0, you get error. Now this is a receiver PDF when plus 1 is transmitted. So when you get error, then this is negative. Okay. So like this, we calculate the probability of error. So you may think it is some difficulty, but try to understand things properly. You'll get it. Okay. Because so we study probability course to calculate probability of error. Or bit error rate. For these two purposes, we study this course. So that's why I'm explaining all these things now itself. You may think it is little bit difficult to understand, but no problem. You try to understand the concept of finding the probability from the PDF or CDF. Okay. Now you must know these graphs, how to draw these graphs. These are very, very important. Okay. So, right. So we stop here. Thank you.